I'm Judy Shaw for NYSE Floor Talk. Joining me today is Sin Sankaran. He is CEO and Chairman at SiriusPoint. Sid, it's great to see you. Thanks for joining me.
Oh, thanks so much for having me, Judy. It's great to be with you again.
A quick note to our viewers, this interview is for informational purposes only. The NYSE doesn't recommend any investments or investment strategies. Okay, so Sid, SiriusPoint recently launched and listed on the NYSE. Can you talk a little bit about what this means for the company?
Well, for both these companies, I think it's pretty clear this is a transformational deal for us. Certainly, we're bringing together two companies in Third Point Re and Sirius Group that are now really creating a meaningful player in the insurance marketplace. We view it as the combined company as a global platform, talented people, and wonderful clients. And so in simple terms, we're big enough to matter, but we aren't too big to change. So we really have the mindset of a startup insurer, and we view ourselves as a new kind of class of 2020 insurance company and are approaching it with that kind of energy. And we all view this as a really, really amazing opportunity.
Now, what's the business focus for the company in the short term?
Well, this probably isn't going to shock you, given the year of losses that the insurance industry had. But for us, the short-term priority is to focus and stabilize the business to generate an underwriting profit. We've had a strong renewal season, and we feel we're off to a good start, but there's a lot more to do. And the reinsurance industry is one that hasn't earned its cost of capital over long time horizons. So discipline and underwriting is what we talk about every single day internally.
All right, now Sid, looking forward, what do you hope SiriusPoint will become in the next 10 years?
Well, I think it's maybe helpful to start with, you know, the big pillars of the company in our mind. You know, first is reinsurance. As I talked about before, we're going to focus on profitable underwriting and on being disciplined around managing the company's balance sheet. You know, the second pillar for us is insurance, you know, which is a division we really want to grow. And we also want to grow it in a different way. We really envision it being a tech-enabled company and focusing on attractive segments of the marketplace. And the third part is insurance services, where we see opportunities to invest in and partner with innovative companies and management teams in the insurance world. You know, we've already established some terrific partnerships. Some of them are what are known as managing general agencies or managing general underwriters, such as IMG, Armada, Arcadian, and we're going to continue to look for expansion in other sectors. But if we look forward to the next decade, what we really want to do is build some alternative business models to respond to how the world and risk is changing. You know, I view insurance as an industry that's completely ripe for change, and we want to be at the forefront of that. If you look at what's happened, really, on the underwriting side, what people perceive as risk changed dramatically overnight with the pandemic, so we can develop solutions that'll help manage it. And technology is changing the industry dramatically. And similar to what we've seen with banking and fintech, we see the exact same opportunity in insurance. So it's certainly in our mind a new kind of insurer. And that's why I always encourage people to look at our new website, because it doesn't look like your standard boring old insurance company.
All right. Now, you have a very diverse board and leadership team. Can you talk a bit about diversity and inclusion and your company culture and values?
Well, it's a great question. I mean, I've kind of watched it become a buzzword in many business sectors, but at SiriusPoint, what we really think about is it's simply about having the best talent. And, you know, I mentioned the website, and Judy, you'll laugh. Somebody said to me, man, I was on the website and I was struck by the diversity of the team. So I actually went on there and looked at it. And then I was thinking, man, we really do look very, very different from the average insurance company. That was exactly the right point for someone to make. But we think about having high talent density in this company. We want to attract, frankly, highly talented people who in many ways have great experience, have been high performing, worked in terrific places, and who all bring a very different worldview to a new insurance company. And, you know, as I think about that problem in insurance, you know, to me, the diversity and inclusion problem in insurance is actually pretty simple. It's a social network of insurance people who've worked together before. They all look the same, walk the same, talk the same. They worked at the same places. So, I mean, we really do focus on the values of the company. Be yourself, be entrepreneurial, be open, be pioneering. Obviously, to me, you know, frankly, as someone who is a person of color and who didn't have a ton of role models as I came up in the industry, the be yourself value is the one that matters the most to me personally. You know, I really do hope that we can continue to be a great role model on D&I, but I hope that we get there just by being ruthless on focusing and great talent.
Okay, and finally, Sid, for your investors and teams who have helped move the merger transaction over the line, what does this launch of SiriusPoint mean to you?
Well, personally for me, I think it's just an exciting time. As I've said, the insurance industry is in a huge point of inflection. We're building a new type of insurance reinsurance company. You know, we've got, as I said, a great opportunity to stabilize what we have and grow the business using tools and innovation and disruption that we think can meaningfully change parts of the insurance sector that we play in. But it's just the beginning for us. It's not even close to the end. So I'm really just excited for all the new opportunities for the company and continuing our journey. So it's a time that's really optimistic and it's full of fun for us and our employees. And I'm very, very grateful for all their hard work to get us to this point.
All right, Sid. Well, it's been wonderful to talk with you and great to have you on NYC Floor Talk.
Great. Thanks so much, Judy.